drives it into right center field. Hit a ton. This baby is way back.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Humm Baby Baseball channel. Today, I'm going to talk a little about the San Francisco Giants offseason. I'm going to give them my own personal grade, how they did in this offseason. And I just watched Marc Giraffe's video, and he gave them an F.
An F? He gave me an F.
So Marc Giraffe feels like the Giants got an F for the offseason, which is cool because, you know, maybe he doesn't follow the Giants that closely, doesn't know all their little moves. But to me, it's not all about competing in 2020. Giants know they're not going to go win a World Series more than likely in 2020. And I think the moves they made were more for their future. That's why they got someone like Will Wilson from the Angels, who was not mentioned in his video. That's why they got someone from the Toronto Blue Jays who can throw 100-mile-an-hour heat in Dany Jimenez. That wasn't mentioned either. Those are two big moves that could really help the Giants in the future. They might not. We'll have to wait and see. But at least they did a couple things to improve down the line. As far as their moves that really helped the team immediately in 2020, their new pickups like Hunter Pence. You got Drew Smyly, Kevin Gausman. Also, they signed Wilmer Flores to compete for a job in the infield. So they got Wilmer Flores. They got Sanchez. They already got Solano. They got plenty of good infielders. So they made a little bit of improvements there. Were the Giants supposed to like trade Joey Bart and all their, you know, young prospects and Hunter Bishop to pick up Mookie Betts for a season? Was that what they were supposed to do? That would have been stupid. So the Giants weren't really in a position to go grab any big-time free agents and improve this team. This is a team that did okay last year. People forget they were third place. So they may have a better season even in 2020. It's possible if certain guys step it up. Now they got Cueto healthy all year. Yeah, they lost Bumgarner. They lost some good players. They lost Will Smith. So theoretically, they're probably not going to be as good. But they could be if guys step it up. Yastrzemski has a big season. And if these new guys like Smyly, if they surprise, if Kevin Gausman surprises and they have big years, you just never know what can happen. It is baseball. But at the same time, the Giants aren't making moves to try to win anything big in 2020. The Giants are making moves for their future. They're gearing up for their future. And that move to get Will Wilson from the Angels was a nice pickup. They get Will Wilson by all they had to do was take on a bad contract from the Angels, and they ended up releasing him anyway, and that was Zach Cozart. So they get Will Wilson, pretty nice prospect. And that also, that Rule 5 draft from the Blue Jays could end up being extremely valuable because, like I said, Dany Jimenez throws heat. Dany Jimenez, now, he may not be big league ready, but if he can find a way to stay on that roster all season, Giants will have him for the long run. So I'm hoping that happens, that they don't have to return him to the Blue Jays. And so far in spring training, he has looked legit. So the Giants made little moves here and there. It wasn't a great offseason, I'll admit that. I'm not saying it's an A+, but an F? I mean, what about the Cubs and the Cardinals? These are teams that actually are good. They actually have a chance to win something in 2020. They might, you know, have a chance to go deep into the playoffs or the World Series. They didn't really improve. They didn't make any moves like the Reds did. The Reds actually improved. The Cubs and Cardinals didn't do anything. And what about the Astros? If anyone deserves an F, what about the Astros? But no, the Giants got an F. Again, obviously, I don't agree with the grade, but I understand it from his point of view because he's not considering all the little moves. He's just considering what makes teams better in 2020. Giants didn't do a lot to improve in 2020. So no doubt, they don't deserve an A. Probably not even a B, if I'm being honest, because they only did pick up a couple prospects. I wish they made a couple more moves and got some more youngsters in that system, in addition to Will Wilson, in addition to Dany Jimenez, even though Jimenez is not really going to be in the system right away. He'll actually be on the 26th man if they want to keep him. But then next year, maybe if he makes it through the year, they can send him back to the minors and get him whatever seasoning he needs. But I think overall, by adding a few youngsters to the team, they did make a couple moves. I wish they did a couple more. I wish they had signed at least one or two outfielders or some, you know, a couple of guys. I wish they hung on to Pilar. Instead, they went with Hunter Pence, which all-time Giant. I mean, Hunter Pence is awesome. 2012, 2014, World Series champ. But last time he was with the Giants, he wasn't playing that well. He had a great year last year with Texas. That doesn't mean he's going to repeat it. I hope he does. But again, I'm not saying it was a great offseason. I think all in all, when we take everything into consideration, the fact that they did pick up Jimenez, they picked up Will Wilson, picked up a couple of starters that might help, picked up a couple of relievers that might help, might not. Got Hunter Pence coming back. Manager, coaches, we got all new managers and coaches except for Wotus, who is still around. But other than that, can't really judge that until we see. I can't tell you that Gabe Kapler was not popular in Philadelphia. They were all too happy to get rid of Gabe Kapler. So it doesn't feel like a super great hire to celebrate, but time will tell how he does. But I understand it wasn't a great off season for the Giants. Could have been a lot better. I was hoping for a lot better, but I'm not going to give him an F. There's no way I'm going to give him an F. You know, the Astros and their fiasco, maybe they get an F because they didn't really bring anybody too valuable either. But all in all, I think C minus is where I'm leaning. I'll give them a C minus, I guess, for their offseason. Let me know what y'all give them. I just wanted to throw out this video because I saw that video on Mark's channel. All due respect, obviously great channel and everything, but F? An F?
He gave me an F!
Have a fantastic day. Hit that subscribe button. Appreciate you guys checking out this video. Gonna have a lot of videos like this. Not always gonna be on site at home. Gonna be doing a lot of traveling. So look for some car videos. Look for some travel videos. I'm gonna hit Globe Life Park this season. Gonna be hitting, trying to go to Dodger Stadium during the All-Star break if I can afford it. Gonna be doing things like, gonna be hitting Busch Stadium and gonna try to go over to Oakland and catch a game over there. Have some stadium reviews for everybody. So look for that in the regular season. But I'm gonna give the Giants a C minus. Tell me what you guys think below. Let me know. I think an F is way too harsh. You guys let me know what you think though. Maybe I'm crazy. Have a fantastic day. Talk to you next time. See ya.
When the Giants come to town.